My dear students of class 10th, I am Rajendra Rai, biology teacher from Alpinium Public School, Golabazar, Gorakhpur, presenting this video for your learning. My dear students, current topic that is going on in this series of the video, that is our environment. Dear students, in our environment, let us study about the food chain. Dear students, as you know, the solar energy, the solar energy provides the energy to all the living beings, and the solar energy, first of all, comes to the producers. Producers which are plants, and the plants manufacture their food for their own as well as for others, and primary consumer, they directly dependent upon the plants which are producers. So this solar energy transfer through the producers to the primary consumer and to the secondary consumer. Secondary consumers which are carnivores. And tertiary consumers, which are again carnivores, as well as the top consumers, which are again carnivores. So this, the solar energy that is transferring from one step to other step of the animals, plants and animals, producer, consumers, and so on, in this way. Dear students, you consider the types of the food chain. There are several types of the food chain: grazing or predator food chain, parasitic food chain, and saprophytic food chain and detritus food chain. Let us explain each and every. Dear students, grazing food chain or predator food chain means the insects which are dependent upon the grass, and that insects get eaten by the frog, and that frog get eaten by the snake, and that snake get eaten by the eagles. So this is the predator food chain or grazing food chain. Second is, that is the deer, that is a grazing animal which is dependent upon the plants, and deer that get hunted by the lion or tiger. So this comes under the grazing or predator food chain. My dear friends, second, that is the parasitic food chain. Parasitic means the parasites are living in the different hosts, and host may be the insect, host may be the mosquito, host may be the human, host may be the pig, host may be the cow. So if a parasite that is present inside the host body, whether that is plant or animals, they meet their requirement of food via this host. So that comes under the parasitic food chain, like amoebic and amoeba and other things. Next is, that is saprophytic. My dear students, some animals which are dependent upon the decomposed type of the dead and decaying food material, that is partially decomposed food, and that decomposed food is for the saprophytic type of the animals which are dependent upon the converted food, decomposed food, and they get some organic and inorganic material from these decomposed food. Next we come to the detritus. This detritus is the, that is for the food availability to the aquatic birds. Aquatic birds are the birds which are living in the water, and these birds, they get the food as decomposed dead bodies. Decomposed dead body. So dear students, this is the food chain, different types of the food chain, and the food chain is in linear. But my dear students, if the food chain get complicated, if the food chain get mixed, then that will be called as food web. So let us discuss about the food web. You have already seen this food chain, and now let us discuss about the food web. Dear students, the food web, that is the mixture of the different types of the food chain. See how this food web is to be represented. Food web. See how this food web is to be represented. Suppose this is an area, this is an ecosystem, and in this ecosystem there are several types of the animals, like lizard, grass, hawk, snake, lion, and ant, plants, ants, and others are deer, others are insects, ants. They dependent upon the grass, and this insect eaten by the frog get eaten by the snake. And this grass, mouse and rabbit see this. Mouse and rabbit. And after that, these mouse and rabbit get eaten by hawk, this mouse get eaten by the snake, and this rabbit again eaten by this lion. Okay, so my dear students, you are looking here that there is a mixing type of the food chain which are present in an ecosystem, and that is more complicated, like insects, they are dependent upon the plants, get eaten by the frog eaten by the snake, and snake, this mouse eaten by the snake. So this snake is getting the food in two ways, while mouse is dependent upon the grass, rabbit is dependent upon the this. And now this lizard get hunted by the hawk get hunted by the snake get hunted by the lion. So this is a mixture of the different types of the food chain is called food web. So dear students, come to the, there is an eco tree. This ecological tree, that is the representation of the food web, different types of the food web. Like suppose this is a tree, there is a branch, there is another branch, then there is another branch, there is another branch, there is another branch, there is another branch, and in the representation of different types of the organisms on this series of the tree, then that will be called as the eco tree. So eco tree, that is the representation method of the food web, which are found in a mixed way. My dear students, after this food web, and now let us come to the trophic level, which we have already discussed in the previous video, little bit about the trophic level. So dear students, now come to the trophic level in detail, and there are different types of the trophic levels as far as the feeding habits of the living organisms are concerned. So the level of the nourishment, each successive level of the nourishment as represented by the link of the food chain, each successful nourishment as represented by the link of the food chain, by the link of the food chain is called trophic level, is known as the definition of the trophic level, that is like this. My dear students, this trophic level is, that is the at the different levels like plants. See, these plants, they will be the first level, number one level. Then the herbivores will be the second level. Then carnivores, they will be the third level. Carnivores, they will be at third level. And last, the carnivores that eat the small carnivores constitute the fourth level. Top level. And they will be our fourth level. So this is the different types of the trophic level which are found in an ecosystem. So dear students, you will learn about the detail of the trophic levels, energy transfer and all the things that will be there in the next video. Thank you very much. Put a like this video and subscribe my channel. Have a great day.